which is present here. So there are so many structures. Either side is for draw karo. Both the sides. Which is a cavernous like honeycomb appearance. This cavernous sinus. Okay. So this is the cavernous. What is this? This is the cavernous sinus. This is the cavernous sinus which is situated like this in pair. Just above, this is the body of the sphenoid. What is this? This is the body of the sphenoid cone. Which view is this? This is the coronal section of the middle cranial fossa where the cavernous sinus is situated. So this is lined by the endothelial lining, this cavernous sinus. Okay, and it is spongy in appearance because it has got large number of communication tributaries. Outgoing channels are there, incoming channels are there, and communication with the external venous systems are there. So that's why it is honeycomb appearance, or you can say the spongy appearance. That's why it is known as cavernous sinus. So now the relation of, now it is clear to all of you how the layers of the dura mater, what it is forming for the cavernous sinus, kaun sa layer kya bana raha hai iska. The endothelial layer, look here, the endothelial layer of the dura mater, it is forming the floor of the cavernous sinus. The meningeal layer, this is forming the lateral wall, ascends upwards, bends medially, and intermedially it becomes continuous with the diaphragma cell, in which there is rupture for the passage of the infundibulum of the pituitary gland, the master gland. Okay, now before going in detail of the internal structure, or first I will like to explain you the internal relations of the cavernous sinus. That means there will be external relation of the cavernous sinus also. So we have drawn the diagram here. So first you see the internal relation observing this diagram. Once the cavernous sinus is asked in full question, then you have to draw a labeled diagram, coronal section of this, along with the pituitary gland, the sphenoid bone either side, and its structures in relation with the lateral wall and the rear, it is present. Or chop here. Look here. This is the lateral wall, or the lateral wall of the cavernous sinus. The space in between the lateral wall and this meningeal layer, there are some spaces, and this which is known as the lateral wall of the cavernous sinus. This relation I am explaining you, the internal relation cavernous sinus ke andar apna khud ka relation, internal relation of the cavernous sinus, above downwards in the viva, or sometimes it is asked, or the MCQ, there are the questions that can describe or enumerate the structure present in the lateral wall of the cavernous sinus above downwards, isn't it? So what you will say, so please see carefully here, it is, there are some structures which are closely related with the lateral wall of the cavernous sinus. Here there is one structure, red chalk rehta to acha hota. Here it is the artery present here, thickwalled artery, and again a nerve here, inferolateral in position to that, isn't it? So what are these? One, I have made four structures here in the lateral wall. One, two, three, and four. This, what is this? Anyone? Yes, very good. What karaya? Very happy. This lateral wall, it is related here with the cranial nerves. Okay, this is the third, starting from the oculomotor nerve, the third and the fourth. It is very easy to remember in this lateral wall why we are starting from the third cranial nerve. Have koi idea? Abhi bataya tha na, the tentorium. Just a recap, the tentorium cerebelli. Recap it. The fixed margin and the free margin, there is an angular interval. I have said there is the angular interval, okay, in between the fixed margin and the free margin. Look here, in this margin there is the emergence of the third and the fourth cranial nerve, and this, after emergence of this, it becomes the structure of the lateral wall of the cavernous sinus. So third cranial nerve, here it is the fourth cranial nerve. Then you must remember there are three parts of the trigeminal nerve, three in bond, three together. Then why only two here structures of the which nerve? Trigeminal. Starting from the ophthalmic, इस तरह से लिखते हैं V1, Roman का ये 2 and the third one where it is present, not in the lateral wall. This is the ophthalmic division of the mandibular nerve. This is the Roman 2, it is the maxillary nerve. That means third, fourth and the two division of the fifth cranial nerve, that is the ophthalmic and the maxillary. It is closely related in the lateral wall of the cavernous sinus. But we know there is the third one also, third nerve also of the trigeminal nerve, which is known as what? Mandibular nerve, isn't it? So where it is present? This is the endosteal layer and this is the bone. In between these two layers, endosteal layer, there is outpouching. Outpouching of the fold of the dura mater here. Okay, which is separated. It is the, in the, here is the site of the trigeminal ganglia. This is the apex of the petrous part, and here there is the site of the trigeminal ganglia, and the roots are going like this in the anterior cranial fossa. Then this ganglia, the body of the ganglia, it is situated here in between the endosteal layer. It is not the part, it is this, the mandibular nerve, it is not the part of the lateral wall. ये cavernous sinus के internal relation में नहीं आता है, तो कहाँ रहता है? It is present outside the cavernous sinus, it is beneath the endosteal layer and the body wall. But the outpouching of the folds of the dura mater, it holds this root or the mandibular nerve, isn't it? So it is outside the cavernous sinus. It is only four nerves. Third is the oculomotor, the fourth trochlear, fifth ophthalmic first, and the second is the maxillary, isn't it? Now, the another internal relation, what are the structure closely related in the inside the sinus itself? That is an artery, a very very important relation of the artery, which later it will help. Which artery is this? Very good, internal carotid artery, very good. Internal carotid artery, it is one of the sources of the blood supply of the brain. It is in pair. I will show you from where it is coming. It is present in the towards the inferomedial aspect, and there is again one nerve. Fifth up till yaha ho gaya, fifth nerve. Sixth also. Sixth, it is only one, that is the abducens nerve. Sixth, it is present inferolateral to the artery. Inferolateral to this artery, that is the internal carotid artery. Okay, now this artery, it is very important, and this nerves for its applied aspect. We will deal the applied aspect of this cavernous sinus. You have to remember this internal relation. Okay, cavernous sinus thrombosis, suppose cavernous sinus thrombosis, what it will lead to? Pressure aayega, kya hoga? The cranial nerves damage, the third, the fourth, the fifth, and the sixth one, and along with an artery here. Sometimes head injury. A case of head injury, there is rupture here. Rupture of what? Arterial wall, which communicates with the venous blood of the cavernous sinus. So the arterial blood here mixes with the venous blood, and what this condition, it is known as arteriovenous fistula. Okay, so this we will discuss, and what will be the impact effect of these relations in the applied, we will discuss later. Now the external relations of the cavernous sinus. External relation, that means external relations, where it is present? Cavernous sinus, it is present here in the middle cranial fossa. Look here, it is situated here, 2 cm long structure. Okay, it is just like that, isn't it? So suppose this chalk is the cavernous sinus, okay, then what are the relation external? इसके ऊपर क्या है? Superior to that, inferior to that, anterior to that, posterior to that, okay, and the medial and the lateral. That means six relation: superior, inferior, the medial, the lateral, anterior, as well as the posterior relation. So for this you have to, this is little bit difficult to let you know by this bone here, because so suppose here it is the cavernous sinus. So what are the structures which are present here? Itna hi dur ka kaam hai, it is only confined here either side. So what are the structures which are superiorly in relation with the cavernous sinus either side? Anyone? That means there are some structures which are coming from the anterior cranial fossa. Ye dekh rahe ho kya hai? What is this? This is the cribriform. Yes, very good. This is the cribriform plate of the ethmoid bone, isn't it? And either side cribriform plate, what, which tract it is coming? Running anterior posteriorly towards the middle cranial fossa. Anyone? First, olfactory tract. Very good. Now here in the middle cranial fossa, just anterior to that, there is the what? Yes, very good. Here it is the superior orbital fissure, and here is the what? Optic canal. In this part there is the optic canal here, through which optic nerve passes and forms the optic chiasma here, isn't it? The optic canal hai, from where the optic nerve is coming, and it is forming of optic nerve, optic chiasma, and then the which tract? Optic tract. Optic tract. So olfactory tract, the optic chiasma, the optic tract. What else? What else in the superior relations? There is the third and the fourth cranial nerve. By the, because here it is the anterior clinoid process. Dekho dhyan se. Here it is the anterior clinoid process, and here it is the posterior clinoid process. यही वो जगह जहाँ पर बनेगा क्या तुम्हारी इमर्ज करेगा द थर्ड एंड द फोर्थ क्रेनियल नर्व. सो इट इज ऑल्सो इन रिलेशन विद द एंटीरियर एस्पेक्ट ऑफ द सुपीरियर सर्फेस ऑफ द कैफर्नस साइनस, दैट इज द थर्ड एंड द फोर्थ क्रेनियल नर्व. एंड वन मोर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट स्ट्रक्चर हियर, एनी वन इन बिटवीन हियर, सपोज हियर इट इज विच पार्ट ऑफ द सेरिब्रम? हियर इट इज द टेम्पोरल लोब. Temporal lobe, the medial most part of the temporal lobe here in the middle cranial fossa, uncus. Very good. The uncus is there. So in this uncus it is present. In between the uncus and the optic chiasma here, there is a very important structure which is again in superior relation of the cavernous sinus, and it is a paired structure. What is that known as? It starts with perforation. Any idea? Anterior. Very good. You go and read today the interpeduncular fossa and its boundary. Okay. Interpeduncular fossa. अगर नहीं पढ़े हैं तो जाकर देखना एक diagram. Diamond shaped area at the base of the skull. There is the base of the brain, and there is the paired anterior perforating substance. इस तरह से paired. Here is the uncus. And here the optic nerve, this is the optic chiasma, and this part it is paired. This is the anterior perforating substance, and in between there is the posterior optic chiasma, and there is the cerebral peduncle also. So anterior perforating substance is there in the superior relation of the cavernous sinus. What do you mean by this perforating substance? Very important question here. What is this? Anterior, मतलब anterior, if I have said, there will be a posterior perforating substance also. That is the component of the internal peduncular fossa, isn't it? So what do you mean by this perforating substances? कुछ substance है, कोई चीज है क्या रखी हुई है वहां पे anteriorly and posteriorly? It is like that. क्या है ये एंटीरियर एंड पोस्टीरियर परफोरेटिंग सब्सटेंस, एंड व्हाई इट इज नोन एज परफोरेटिंग सब्सटेंस? इट इज नथिंग, जस्ट सिंपली दिस परफोरेटिंग सब्सटेंस, इट इज नथिंग, इट इज अ शीट ऑफ ग्रे मैटर, इजंट इट? शीट ऑफ ग्रे मैटर विच इज प्रेजेंट लाइक दैट एंटीरियर एस्पेक्ट एंड वन पोस्टीरियर एस्पेक्ट, एंड इट इज नोन एज परफोरेटिंग. व्हाई? because in the, when you will discuss later in the class, the blood supply of brain, isn't it? There is circle of Willis. Just like the basilar venous plexus, there is circle of Willis also, which is a very important part for related with the blood supply of brain. And there, the deep branches, the striate branches. Okay? The circle of Willis, there is a component, striate branches, which is piercing these gray matter sheets to supply the deeper structures of the brain. That's why it is known as the, if it is anteriorly placed, impaired, that is anterior perforating substance, and posteriorly placed, it's a posterior perforating substance. Okay?